Supplying aid in an emergency used to be mainly bringing in ships, planes, trucks, transporting items from overseas, and then distributing to beneficiaries. In this way of working, the supply chain looks something like this. But often this can bypass what was already in the area, the local market system.
Whatever we do in an emergency has an impact on markets, but bypassing the local market and only bringing in materials from outside can impact prices, availability, access, and can even cause local traders to go out of business. Where markets are functioning after a crisis, giving cash or vouchers can be an effective tool to get assistance to beneficiaries.
For all kinds of things, like food, household items, water, shelter, and even medicines.
And this can boost local markets, increasing trade.
But what happens when we give a beneficiary cash without understanding the market? What if they go to their local trader only to find there are no goods on the shelves?
Let's roll back the clock a little.
Let's say the beneficiary and the small trader are in a slum on the outskirts of the city. The trader gets their goods from different places.
The household goods come from a distributor who brings a small truck into the market once a week.
The distributor gets them from a large store in the capital city by road once a month.
Some of the food in the shop comes from big supermarkets who get it from wholesalers,
who get it from millers and producers, and some of the food comes from farmers who grow on plots of land nearby.
So you see, for each type of commodity, there's a complicated market system to get to know. We need to understand all the pieces of the puzzle, the whole supply chain, to know which way to work in an emergency. And these chains can be vulnerable and can take time to be affected. Goods might be on the shelves for now, but what about in a month?
Let's go back to the small trader. Remember, they get their household goods once a week from the distribution truck. But what if there are fuel shortages after the emergency and the truck driver can't get diesel anymore?
Or what about further up the chain? Things might work okay for a few weeks, but what if a bridge is damaged? This will have a knock-on effect to the small trader down the line.
And can put at risk the delivery of our projects to beneficiaries in need.
So what does all this mean? Well, when we work with cash, there's still a supply chain to engage in, and we need to work with others to monitor the supply chain, making sure beneficiaries can access what they need.
And we need to be agile enough
to switch back to delivering directly if the market system isn't functioning or takes a turn for the worst.
And when it's functioning again, we can switch back to delivering the local market system.
We all want to make the right decisions in an emergency and have the most impact. That means we need to get to know our local market systems, monitor while we're delivering, and maintain our own supply chain for when it's needed.